You can use the Laplace transform and inverse Laplace transform to convert functions between the time domain and the Laplace domain, also known as the S domain. This conversion is very important for analog systems that are linear time invariant, or LTI, because the properties of the Laplace transform help you to determine the LTI system output for a given input signal. In this video, I'm presenting five important properties of the Laplace transform. These are linearity, derivatives, integrals, delays, and convolution. If you know these properties and have a Laplace transform table, then you can find many Laplace transforms and inverse Laplace transforms. The convolution property is especially important because you can use convolution in the time domain to calculate the output signal from an LTI system. We'll also get to that in this video. Let's start with linearity. The Laplace transform is a linear operation. This means that if you multiply a time domain function by a constant, then its corresponding S domain function is multiplied by the same constant. Also, if you add two time domain functions together, then their Laplace transform is simply the sum of the transforms of the two separate time domain functions. Derivatives are a bit more complicated. If you know the Laplace transform of a function f of t, but you want the Laplace transform of the time derivative of f of t, then you can take the Laplace transform of the original function, multiply it by s, and subtract the value of the time domain function at time 0. You can prove this property directly from the definition of the Laplace transform. This proof requires integration by parts, but it only takes a few steps because it just requires a generic time domain function and the integral of the exponential function. One of the terms that you're left with is simply the original Laplace transform, and you get to the final result. Higher order derivatives can be found by repeatedly applying the property for the first order derivative. For example, the Laplace transform of the second time derivative of f is s squared times the Laplace transform of f, subtract s times the value of the time domain function at time 0, minus the value of the first time derivative of function f at time 0. If you ignore the value of the function f at time 0, then you can summarize the Laplace transform of the derivative by saying that taking a derivative in the time domain is the same as multiplying by s in the Laplace domain. Similarly, it turns out that integration in the time domain, from time equals 0 to infinity, is the same as dividing by s in the Laplace domain. Now let's talk about delays. Delaying a signal in time by a constant is the same as multiplying the signal by a complex exponential of s in the Laplace domain, where the coefficient of the exponent scales with the constant delay. Similarly, a shift in the s domain by a constant is the same as multiplying the signal by an exponential of t in the time domain, where again the coefficient of the exponent scales with the constant shift. Finally, we come to convolution. It's arguably the most important Laplace transform property if you're studying linear time invariant, or LTI, systems. We know that the output of an LTI system can be found by convolving the input with the system's impulse response. If you convert the convolution operation to the Laplace domain, then you get multiplication. So convolution in the time domain is the same as multiplication in the S domain. Multiplication in the S domain is generally much easier than solving a convolution integral in the time domain, even if you start in the time domain and first need to convert the system and input functions from time to Laplace. This is such a common procedure that there's a special name for the Laplace transform of a system impulse response. This is called the system transfer function. So, to summarize, you now have a workflow to find the time domain output of an LTI system when given an input signal and the system impulse response. First, using properties of the Laplace transform, or entries in the Laplace transform table, you convert the input signal and the impulse response to the Laplace domain. Second, you multiply them together to get the output in the Laplace domain. Finally, you take the inverse Laplace transform to arrive at the time domain output. We'll see examples of this workflow in future videos. Thanks for watching. If you liked it, let me know. You can leave a comment with any feedback or subscribe for more of this series on signal processing. There's also a lecture notes PDF in the description. See you next time.